Hello everyone, welcome back to the continuation of our dental age estimation methods. So last session we finished the Damijian's method of radiographic dental age estimation. Today's session is about the morphological method, that is the Gustafsson method of dental age estimation. So XY bow means, I told you, we need to remove the tooth with minimal alteration and do the examination to estimate the age. So it is a morphological method. So in 1950, Gustafsson introduced this age estimation method based on the morphologic and histological changes of the tooth. So he has six criteria, and based on this six criteria he planned the age estimation. So the six stages are, or the six criteria are, the first one is the amount of occlusal attrition, then the loss of periodontal attachment indicated by A, indicated by P, then the coronal secondary dentine deposition. So it is secondary dentine denoted by S, then the root resorption at the apex denoted by R, then the dentine translucency denoted by T, and the cementum apposition at the root apex. So for each these regressive changes, we formulated 0 to 3 scores. So we need to check the tooth for these changes. For each change, we need to score 0, there is no change, 1 with minimal change, 2 moderate and severe change. So for attrition, we need to check the teeth. If it is moderately attrited, we are going to put score 2. If the root resorption is moderate, we are going to put 2. If the cementum at apex is more, we are going to give 3. So likewise, we are going to finally get a score. Okay, that is score X. So all these scores will be added and we get a score X. Okay, and finally we get our age by a formula, that is 11.43 plus 3.63 into X. So this X is here, we get by doing all this calculation. Okay, so this is how we calculate Gustafsson's method of age. So you might be wondering where this 11.43 and 3.63 came from. This is actually a regression equation. It is a mathematical regression equation put forward by this Gustafsson. Okay, so it has finally reached to a standardized value. This is a constant and this is a coefficient, so you can put any X value and we'll get a generalized population age. So that is how this regression equation works. So Gustafsson's regression equation is this one, 11.43 plus 3.63 into X, whereas the Maples and Rice corrected this formula. Maples and Rice, two scientists, corrected this formula. They changed the constant value, that is age is equal to 13.45 plus 4.26 into our X. So suppose this X is 5, we are going to multiply 3.63 into 5 and add to this 11.43. okay, so in this case it will be increased. Here both the values are more. In place of 11.43 in Maples and Rice, he said it is, or it should be 13.45 and 4.26 into this 5. So we get any number of X in a particular, it changes from person to person. Whereas Johnson has again modified this formula. Johnson modified the formula like this. Before that he modified the scoring numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 modified into 0,
0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5 and 3. He added a 0.5 in between. And he completely renovated this formula as 11.02 is a constant. Then each value will be added with coefficient, that is 5.14 into the value of A, 2.3 into the value of S, 4.14 into the value of P, then 3.17 into the value of C, 5.57 into value of R, and 8.98 into the value of T. So finally we get the age. So this is a mathematical regression equation. First, Gustafson modified, 11.43 plus 3.63 into X, then Maple Sunrise, 13.45 plus 4.26 into X. But Johnson completely renovated, that is 11.0 into all these. Each will be separately multiplying with the regressive changes. So this is how we calculate Gustafson method. So this method is basically directly we do examination, morphological examination on the 6 criteria with a score of 0, 1, 2, 3, and we get the score of X and we apply it on the equation, so, or Johnson's method. Whereas the first one, what we studied is the Damigian's method. It is a radiographical method. We calculate it by various stages and converting into score and adding up the scores and comparing with the standardized table. So that's all about two methods, Gustafson and Damigian's method. So next important topics in age estimation will be covered in future sessions. Hope you understood this method, Gustafson and Damigian. You need to write all the content when writing for your exam. Okay, so I'll come up with those sessions and then this GM mod. Thank you.